Your first computational project will be to compute the bifurcation diagram for the logistic map. I think in order to have a better understanding of what you're seeing from your computation, it's worthwhile to give you a little bit of a theoretical background. The logistic map is a type of one-dimensional map. A one-dimensional map we can write as x n plus 1 equals some function of xn. Usually the function has some parameter. In the logistic map, the parameter we'll call mu. But let me just write it like this. This is an iteration. A map is an iteration. The idea of an iteration is you start with some initial value, let's say x naught, and then you plug it into the right-hand side, and then you get the next value of the map, which would be x1. Then you take x1 and you put it into the right-hand side, and you get the next value, which would be x2, and so on. So a one-dimensional map, like our logistic map, will give us a sequence of values of x. It's important to understand that certain solutions, you can get certain solutions from this map. One of them is called a fixed point. So a fixed point solution we can call x star is a fixed point. Fixed means that it doesn't change. So if it solves x star equals f of x star, okay? So a one-dimensional map can have fixed points where the solution doesn't change on iteration. You would then get x star, x star, x star forever, okay? The logistic map also has fixed points, which we'll derive later. So if you have a fixed point, however, can be stable or unstable. So a stable fixed point means that if you start close to a fixed point, your iterates will then converge to the fixed point. An unstable fixed point means that if you start close to the fixed point, but you iterate, your iterates will diverge from the fixed point, will move away from the fixed point. So we would like to have some analytical theory which tells us whether a fixed point is stable or unstable. That's called linear stability analysis. So we can do a linear stability analysis. To do a linear stability analysis, you need to translate what I just said verbally into mathematics. So we want to be close to a fixed point and see how the distance from the fixed point changes. So what we do is we let x sub n be close to the fixed point, be equal to x star, plus slightly away from the fixed point. So I'm going to call that epsilon sub n. So at the nth iteration, then, we're just a little bit away from the fixed point. And we want to see how xn plus 1 behaves. So xn plus 1, then, would be close to the fixed point. But with one more iteration, we would have epsilon n plus 1. Okay. So if epsilon n plus 1 is moving further away from the fixed point, then epsilon n, then we say the fixed point is unstable. If, on the other hand, epsilon n plus 1 is decreasing the distance to the fixed point, then we say that the fixed point is stable. So now what we would like is an equation for these epsilons. So we go to our one-dimensional map. So x sub n plus 1 becomes x star plus epsilon n plus 1. And f of xn becomes f of x star plus epsilon n. And epsilon is supposed to be close to the fixed point. It's called a linear stability analysis because we can assume that epsilon is very small. And that when we do a Taylor series, we only need to keep the linear term. Okay. In numerical analysis, we're always doing Taylor series. So we'll do a Taylor series here. A Taylor series then about X star would be F of X star plus epsilon n times F prime of X star. And we're only going to keep linear terms. So there'll be other terms here, plus dot, 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 but we will drop them in a linear stability analysis. F of X star is just equal to X star because X star is a fixed point. And then we have epsilon n F prime of X star. And I'm going to drop the higher order terms. Okay, X star cancels. We can divide through by epsilon n. So we get epsilon n plus 1 divided by epsilon n is equal to F prime of X star. We're interested in whether epsilon n plus 1 is becoming larger in magnitude than epsilon n. If that's the case, then it's unstable. So we're actually interested in the magnitude here. So we have this result, okay? So X star can be stable or unstable. So it's stable or unstable if one of two things, right? It's stable if epsilon n plus 1 over epsilon n in magnitude is smaller than 1, right? So you're moving towards the fixed point. So it's stable if F prime of X star is smaller than 1. On the other hand, if you're moving away from the fixed point, epsilon n plus 1 over epsilon n would be larger than 1. The epsilons are getting bigger, so it's unstable if F prime of X star is greater than 1, okay? So that's a criteria for whether a fixed point is stable or unstable. So this is some general theory for a one-dimensional map. You can find fixed points, and you can determine the stability of the fixed points. For your project, you're going to do the logistic map. So let me write down the logistic map. So we have x sub n plus 1 equals mu, which is our parameter, times x sub n times 1 minus x sub n. So it's what's called a quadratic map with mu a parameter. Here, this mu then is going to, we're going to restrict it to be between 0 and 4. Okay? So those are the restriction on the parameter. So the project is to compute the bifurcation diagram. So it's to compute the behavior of these iterates as mu varies. Okay? So as mu increases from 0 up to 4, how do the x's behave? So one will plot the iterates x versus mu, okay, in a graph, x versus mu. And that will give us our bifurcation diagram. Okay. For small values of mu, we'll have a fixed point. So it's useful in order to interpret your bifurcation diagram to understand the fixed point behavior here. So if we want to compute the fixed points of the logistic map, we can compute x star, right, equals mu x star times 1 minus x star. So that will be the equation for the fixed point of the logistic map. One solution is x star equals 0, right? If x star is not 0, we can divide through by x star. So the other solution satisfies 1 equals mu times 1 minus x star. We can solve that for x star. So we get x star If you do the arithmetic, we get 1 minus 1 over mu, okay? So the logistic map then has two fixed points. But when you plot the bifurcation diagram, if the fixed point is stable, then you will, after you get rid of your transient iterations, you'll see just one point. So a stable fixed point would be one value, and then it would vary in mu. So you would just get a line on this bifurcation diagram if the fixed point is stable, okay? So we should figure out then when is the zero fixed point stable, when is the 1 minus 1 over mu fixed point stable. To do that, we need to calculate the derivative of the right-hand side as a function of x. So the right-hand side is f is mu x times 1 minus x. So here the derivative of the right-hand side would be mu minus x squared is 2x, so minus 2 mu x, okay? Then we use our criterion for stability to analyze the fixed points. So f prime of 0 then is equal to mu. So this will be stable for mu smaller than 1, right? So mu is going from 0 to 4. So f prime of 0 is less than 1 as long as mu is between 0 and 1. Okay, that's a rather boring fixed point because you're just doing 0, 0, 0, 0, right? 0 is always a fixed point solution. But something interesting happens when 0 becomes unstable. So when mu is larger than 1, the second fixed point then becomes stable. So what is the value of f prime of this second fixed point? 1 minus 1 over mu. So you substitute x equals 1 minus 1 minus mu into this derivative. And if you then simplify the math, you get 2 minus mu. Okay? So this fixed point is larger than 1 when mu is between 0 and 1. So actually, well, first of all, it's negative, which is we're only considering positive x. So small mu, this thing is not very useful. But then this will become stable when mu is larger than 1. So when mu is larger than 1, we end up with 2 minus 1 is 1. And then 2 minus 1 plus something will be smaller than 1, which means this fixed point is stable, right? But this fixed point will become unstable again when mu is larger than 3. So 2 minus 3 is minus 1. So when the derivative is the absolute value of the derivative is greater than 1, you get instability. So then when mu becomes larger than 3, this fixed point will be unstable. So this is stable when mu then is between 1 and 3, okay? So it will start at 0 and then come up and to some fixed point. And then at a value of 3 here in the plot, something special will happen. So the two fixed points of the logistic map will both be unstable, and something interesting will happen then when mu is greater than 3. What will happen is you will get what's called a bifurcation, and you'll end up with a period 2 cycle, which will be two fixed points. So you'll have two fixed points. You'll have x star and x double star. And what will happen in the iterations is you'll go from f of x star equals x double star and f of x double star equals x star. So you will just bounce back and forth between two values of x. Okay? That will happen when mu is larger than 3. And then even more interesting, it will bifurcate again, to a period 4 cycle, and then it will bifurcate again to a period 8 cycle, and then eventually you'll get these x values then that have no real pattern to them, and this is what we call chaos. Okay, so you'll see chaos in the logistic map. So let me summarize. You're going to be doing the bifurcation diagram of the logistic map as your project to have some sort of theoretical understanding of what you're doing. I wanted to discuss the general theory of these one-dimensional maps. The simplest type of theory is the fixed point analysis. Find the fixed point of the map and then do a linear stability analysis of your fixed points. For the logistic map, we showed that there are two fixed points. The zero fixed point is stable when mu is smaller than 1. And then the 1 minus 1 over mu fixed point is stable when mu is between 1 and 3. Then funny things will happen when mu is greater than 3. And that's what the project is about. You're supposed to compute what happens. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.